to One United. This is Wali Siddiqui, and Paritosh Joshi is here with us for a second.
Hello.
For talking us. So let's start by talking about Manchester United's recent results. And the last time we met Paritosh, we were quite confident and we thought that we're going to pummel Everton 3-0 or 2-0. But
you were saying 3-0 or 2-0. I was.
You said it was going to be 3-1. I remember.
3-1 or 2-1. 3-1 or 2-1, yeah.
Yeah, we were wrong, right? So, why are we so naive? We always play well against the top six. And whenever it comes to the lesser teams, with all due respect, why do we always falter to get the points?
Robin Hood of the Premier League. We're the Robin fucking Hood of the English Premier League. We take the points from the top teams and we give away to the smaller teams. And that's the case with Manchester United. And sadly, yeah, we're going through a rough phase. What can you say? The performance against Everton, especially the second half performance, I am disappointed in the way that we were playing. We were quite hesitant in creating chances. There was not much creative influence. And in the final third especially, I had special complaints with players not able to get across, break the final line with perfection. Or more often than not, the traps of the defensive side, they were working. We were not able to clear the lines. And that's the case when the first goal was conceded. We were not able to clear it on time. Yes, the VAR and the hand that pushed David De Gea, that can be questioned. But you can't really blame everything on the VAR or how the decisions will go your way. Tough teams or champion teams, they defeat the teams no matter what the odds. And that's the case. We are not able to break through. We had an inspirational player in Mason Greenwood, but Marcus Rashford wasn't at his particular best. Daniel James, he was good. Again, there were some, I'd say some questionable performances, but we'll talk about that later.
And we were going to talk about that, but before that, let's just talk about us as a collective unit, because there was an interesting stat which I went through, and it was that Manchester United, whenever they have dominated the possession at home or away, whenever it's been 55% or more than that in terms of ball possession, Manchester United have failed to register a win in the Premier League this season. And whenever it's been below 50%, we've managed to win or get a draw. But as far as we're talking about dominating possession, we haven't been able to win a game, which is quite surprising, quite shocking. And we need to come up with a solution such as this, because at this point, it's quite easy to stop Manchester United. Even if you're a top six club from the next time, I think they're going to be wary of this fact. And they will also sit back and relax and hit Manchester United on the counter. And I think that might just be it for us.
Yeah, we've seen this time and again, and especially someone like Jose Mourinho, because this is not even the Christmas time yet. There's still much football left in the Premier League. And we'll have to face these clubs again. Especially, I'm wary of when Manchester United go to Tottenham against Jose Mourinho, then it'll be a big, big problem. We'll have to face someone like Jose Mourinho, who's a very smart customer. He won't fall into the trap once again. He won't be letting the team press again and again. He's very smart. He'll play dogged and he'll get away with the result. Ole Gunnar Solskjaer needs to sort this out, especially, I think this will all get a bit sorted when Paul Pogba returns, but I'm not sure how much he can sort things out. Yes, he's a great player. He's a creative player and he's someone who holds creative influence. But I'm not sure one player would do it for you. I think January transfer windows will be crucial in the Premier League run.
And we need reinforcements in midfield, because we take possession and if you're not able to score a goal, it just means that we do not have that creative.